Namaskar students, let's start the function of stomach. The inner lining of the stomach contains gastric glands. The gastric gland secretes gastric juice that contains hydrochloric acid, protein digestive enzyme called pepsinogen and mucus. Hydrochloric acid creates an acidic medium that helps to convert inactive pepsinogen into active pepsin. This pepsin help to partially digest protein. Hydrochloric acid also kills the germs that may have entered along with the food. If we are talking about mucus, the mucus protects the inner lining of the stomach from the action of acid under normal condition. If there would be no mucus in the stomach, it would lead to corrosion of inner lining of stomach and thus would result into ulcer in stomach. In stomach, the food is converted into partially digested pulpy mass called chyme. The food remains in the stomach for about 3 hours. The exit of food from the stomach is regulated by a sphincter muscle which releases it in small amounts into the small intestine. From the stomach, the semi-digested food enters into the small intestine. Though it is called small intestine, but it is the longest part of the alimentary canal and about 6 meter long and highly coiled structure. It has 3 different parts: duodenum, jejunum and ileum. Duodenum is the shortest C-shaped part of the small intestine. The bile duct from the liver and the pancreatic duct from the pancreas pour their secretion into the duodenum. In jejunum, no chemical reaction takes place. Ileum, the digestive process completed in this part. The small intestine is actually the site of complete digestion of carbohydrate, proteins and in small intestine, semi-digested food mixes with bile juice, pancreatic juice and intestinal juice. Let's talk about liver. Liver is the largest gland present in our body that secretes bile juice. And the bile juice gets stored in the gallbladder. The bile juice is secreted to the duodenum with the duct. Okay. The chyme which enters the small intestine from the stomach is acidic. But the pancreatic juices and the intestinal enzymes cannot work in acidic medium. So, bile juice provides alkaline medium for the proper functioning of these enzymes. Bile also helps in the emulsification of fat. Now what is that? It is the breaking of large fat globules present in intestine into smaller globules, as intestinal enzyme cannot act on larger fat globules. Let's talk about the function of pancreas. The pancreas secretes pancreatic juice which is extremely rich in digestive enzymes such as amylase, pancreatic lipase and trypsin, which drain into the duodenum. These enzymes further break down the partially digested food particles into simpler molecules. For example, amylase acts on partially digested starch and complex sugars and converts them into maltose. The pancreatic lipase acts on the fats and converts them into fatty acids and glycerol. And trypsin acts on proteins and converts them into peptides. The food passes into the ileum. Here, this is the last part of the small intestine, which contain intestinal glands that secretes intestinal juices, and complete digestion of the food occurs here. Now I have made the full chart over here. You can note down the function as I have explained. Just you pause this video and note down the function of each part. Okay, this after this complete digestion, you can see over here the lipids by the action of lipase, fatty acid and glycerol, proteins into trypsin by the action of trypsin into amino acid, and then starch by the action of amylase, that is the simple sugar, or that is glucose. One thing I want to mention over here, the length of the small intestine differ in various animals depending on the food they eat. Herbivores feeding on green plants need a longer small intestine to digest the cellulose completely. As the process of digestion of cellulose takes a long time. On the other hand, carnivores consumes flesh as their diet. As compared to cellulose, meat is easier to digest, and therefore carnivores have a shorter small intestine. Now, the digested food that is in the liquid form should be absorbed. Now, how it occurs? The process of conversion of digested food into substances that can be absorbed and assimilated by an organism is called absorption. The digested food is absorbed by the walls of the intestine. The inner lining of the small intestine has numerous finger-like projections called villi. The villi increases the surface area for absorption. Each villus is supplied with blood capillaries and lymph vessels. The absorbed food is taken by the blood capillaries to each and every cell of the body. The cells then use the food to obtain energy, build new tissues and repair old tissues. The digested food remains in the small intestine for nearly 4 hours. The next step is the assimilation of food. The process in which the components of food are taken to each and every cell of the body after the food has been digested and absorbed is called assimilation. The properly ingested, digested and absorbed food used for obtaining energy, growth and repair of the body. Now, the undigested food, that is in the semi-solid form, it passes to the large intestine. The large intestine is about 1.5 to 1.8 meter long and about 6.5 centimeter in diameter. Now it has 3 parts: cecum, colon and rectum. Cecum is a small pouch. This is the cecum, is a small pouch at the junction of small and large intestine. A narrow worm shaped tube called vermiform appendix, okay, projects from the cecum. The appendix is a functionless vestigial organ, and when inflamed due to infection, it may cause appendicitis. The colon is a continuous part of cecum and is situated in the right side of the abdominal cavity. In colon, the absorption of water and the formation of feces takes place. Rectum is the last part of the large intestine. The feces is stored here and then removed from the body through anus. With this, we come to the end of the first light process, that is nutrition.